So this is how the selection is made on random, and then you can apply your audit procedures. इस तरह से ये sample size. अब आप arbitrarily determine कर लें कि how many numbers you want. Okay? आपको कितने इसमें से 4000 में से invoice select करने, 200, 10, 50, 30, whatever. So it will keep on doing it. So randomly it will be selected. Okay. So this was about random selection. And as I said, the problem with this is that you need to have a particular sequence. If you don't have a sequence, you cannot correspond it. Okay? So it may be difficult to establish correspondence between the random numbers and the items in population. Systematic selection. Now here you don't need random table. What do? We simply take out the population. Annexure 2 you can refer. So this was a random table, was annexure 1. What do? Verification of debtors, population debtors 3 million, sampling unit account balances total in total 1500. Tolerable error is 100,000. Sample size we need 174, for example. So now here we create a sampling interval. Sampling interval is created by dividing population divided by sample size. So we have every 17,241 rupees of debtors we will select. So if you look at next page, monetary sampling selection evaluated. Your sample interval is 17,241. Okay. So I have closed it. I have not defined all the 1500 units. It will be very lengthy. You can do it if you want. So 17,241 is our interval. Account balances. These are the sampling units actually we have to select. Then we create accumulative balances. We add up one balance after another. And then we run, whether manually or through computer. It will select at every 17,241. Again, here also we need a blind start. कहीं तो आपको start करना हो ना blind, ठीक है? तो आप कहीं से भी blind start कर लें. So number three सामने इसमें sorry number two से किया, तो 8,000 पहला sample तो हम ऐसे ही select कर लें, 8,190. Then we keep on adding 17,241, okay? And then we will see 22,241. Yes, it is falling in 22,300. So 14,110 has been selected, so and so forth. So this is a systematic way of selecting, but in this case this is not the one that we are talking of here. This is a modified form of a systematic selection, which is MUS. The steps are same, so that is why instead of going through all this, I have given you a practical, you can view the steps we have discussed. The steps are same, but this is a modified version. If you are not talking of values, and if you are talking of only items, in that case you need to be very, very careful. Your items should not be arranged in such a manner that either all of that particular item is selected or none of the item is that item is selected. For example, see, normally what do? The bank adjustments, direct debits, we always do it at the month end. You know, we get the information from the banks and then we record. If all our entries are coming at the end of the month and our sample interval is such that every debt item is either selected or every debt particular item is always missed out, ठीक है, तो वो उसमें आएगी नहीं, so then representative sample will not be drawn. So you have to look at the data also and then you have to see and accordingly devise the sample which should not run. But this would be more the case with the when we are selecting on the basis of quantitative numbers rather than values. Normally this problem will not be there if we are doing it on debtors or this is just what we have discussed and this is what the example is with you, the annexed attachment 2. Para 8 of ISA 530 discusses this sample. This particular method. In considering the characteristics of the population, the auditor may determine that stratification or value-weighted selection is appropriate. So we have discussed this. I don't think we need any deliberation on that. We have already covered, and each individual rupee has a chance, but it cannot be selected individually. But it is included in that sample interval. So in a way we can say that every rupee has a chance of being selected. So I'm just explaining because you will be having a handout with you, and in my absence when you read that handout you can easily understand what I mean. Okay. So the benefit of the method is that efforts are all concentrated towards large value item without being biased. देखो उसमें तो हम बायस हो जाते हैं ना, हम देखते हैं कौन सी बड़ी आइटम है तो बड़ी बड़ी आइटम ले ले. यहाँ वी आर नॉट बायस, वी लेफ्ट इट टू सम प्रोसेस, बट वी हैव डिफाइंड द प्रोसेस इन सच अ मैनर दैट इट वुड ट्राई टू लोकेट हाई वैल्यू आइटम्स. ठीक है, जरूरी नहीं है कि हमेशा वो हाई वैल्यू आइटम, कभी लो वैल्यू भी सेलेक्ट कर सकता है, लेकिन ज्यादातर चांसेस है कि इट विल कैच हाई वैल्यू आइटम्स बिकॉज ऑफ अ क्यूमुलेटिव टोटल. हैपहैज़र्ड सिलेक्शन, ठीक है, जस्ट हैपहैज़र्डली यू सेलेक्ट अ सैंपल एंड बट डेफिनेटली एनी स्ट्रक्चर टेक्निक इज नॉट फॉलोड बट at times it is probably the only practical method when we are dealing with small items like posting of repairs and maintenance and all that. This is the problem with haphazard selection. We are looking at data, ठीक है, तो statistically अगर आपको कोई कहे कि भाई आओ जाके data collect करके आओ, तो यार ये वाली गली में नहीं जाना है यार, बड़ा मुश्किल है, ठीक है, छोड़ो यार. ओके, आई स्टिल रिमेंबर व्हेन वी वर डूइंग अ फिजिकल वेरिफिकेशन ऑफ वन ऑफ अवर क्लाइंट. तो क्लाइंट में वो जो मैनेजमेंट रिप्रेजेंटेटिव वाज देयर, तो वी हैव आल्सो शेयर्ड विद देम बिकॉज इट वाज अ मोर ऑफ अ कंसल्टेंसी असाइनमेंट अदर देन ऑडिट, सो वी वर शेयरिंग इट एंड इट वाज अ होटल. तो ही केम वेरी फास्ट, यार हो गया, बोलते हाँ, वी वर स्वेटिंग ऑल, कैसे हो गया, बोलते यार तुम लोगों में कॉमन सेंस नहीं है, एक डबल बेड में क्या होगा, एक सिंगल बेड में क्या होगा, ठीक है, एक बेड होगा, एक ये होगा, और बाथरूम में क्या क्या होगा, वगैरह वगैरह. सो इट वॉज अ टेक ओवर एंड द असाइनमेंट वॉज टू टेक द फिजिकल स्टॉक ऑफ इंटायर असेट्स. सो दिस इज कॉल्ड वेन यू नो अ बायस इन द केस ऑफ अ कॉन्शियस बायस, स्पेशली यू अवॉइड लोकेटिंग अ डिफिकल्ट आइटम्स और यू ट्राई टू कैच दोज आइटम्स which gives you a favorable result. So it is not statistical sampling ke liye, so it's not advisable because they cannot measure the probability of an item being selected. Or वैसे भी every item does not have a equal chance in the sense ke if the bias is introduced. If the bias is not there, then we can argue ke at least they don't have an equal chance, but every item has a chance of being selected. Okay, but since we are looking with our bare eye, so with some purpose we are selecting those items. Block selection.